Okay. Camera and cord. Okay, it's getting dark outside, but luckily I do have a big light out here that is already on. It's just not, it's dusk now, it's not dark yet. It's gonna be dark quick. I can see that. So, well, I should be able to finish drilling those holes. See, there should be enough light. It's just enough, I think, that I can do it. Afraid when that camera moves a little bit, I'll be too low, too high either. Okay. I'm actually close enough that I think I can get it here in a little while. I keep closing this up because the clouds are keep rolling around. I mean, now it's kind of, that's one reason why it's darker, because of the clouds right now too. I just now realized again. We could probably have quite a bit more light if it wasn't for the clouds. Gotten all hazy now, it's not just spotty. Okay, so anyway, that's why I keep wasting time putting all, you know, kind of closing all this up when I'm not actually going. Let's see. Let's go ahead and mark our spots. I need to, well, actually, I think I'll try and drill them from the back side, I think. No? Oh, we'll have to. Yeah, because I can't clamp it down good. There's really not enough room to clamp it down unless I flip it over. That'll be fine. I have to go get the vice grips again. But I'll mark where. Use this calipers to mark where that is. You can use it as a scribe. That's pretty. I may have to go get my drop light. I can't see. I thought I could see up here. Okay. Use that marker. I'll use that. I don't really like marking on my calipers, but I don't care. Okay, let's see. Alright, let's go to the center of that hole. So I just want to. If you know exactly where those holes are. There we go. Now, and this one is not the same at all. That's okay. Not really gonna matter. Okay, so I needed to, yeah, that's the side I wanted to go. So now I know for sure that I can go pretty much anywhere in the area that I can reach. Sheet metal screw in there, and then take. I have to do three so I can take. Mm-hmm. could do the drilling in there and drill through this and the washer dryer at the same time. Drill a pilot hole in here and then run those screws through. But really, I really need to have two men at all times to keep it straight. And to see, I can look at it and see that it looks straight too, maybe. But I really need to do the, I don't know if that'll work. Let's see. Yeah, I can do three. I mean, it's not that I don't want to do three. Down low will be sheet metal. I guess I should get a sheet metal screw that I'm planning on using. I measure it. Yeah, I'll drill four holes, put it up there with sheet metal screws, and then I'll probably take the top two out and drill for quarter 20 bolts. Some sheet metal screws, and I'm not gonna go move the camera for that. To hold it on there. Yeah, this would be a good way to do it. These are, I think, yeah, 10 by 16 by 1 quarter size. And, they're long enough to get plenty of thread. They're self-tapping, but they would go through this, but it's going to be better to drill pilot holes. If I get my magnifying glass, I can probably see it. 165, okay. So it's not a... I was going to say they're probably an eighth inch, but they're bigger than that. That's fine. might be the same one I used a while ago. No, not that one. Let's see. Yep, it's that one there. By the time I drill that hole, that's like a 160 drill, I think. That's a 175. See if that was right. Yeah, that's just right. A little bigger than that. That doesn't really let it go all the way through. So the one that I started out with is just what I need. I think to see my mark, my punch marks, I'm going to have to go get that line. Something like that. Oh, I've got a light that I have a six-way out here, though. I got another light that's on a stand. That's what I need. There's no place to hang that proper light. It wouldn't be any harder to do. I also need my... I better ship the box of screws before I turn them over. Go get light. Put my light, but here it is. Let's see. I think I better put it behind me here. Yeah. Behind the camera, maybe now. I gotta go get a six way. So I'll put it in with this cord with the camera. Now I better plug it into the same place my drill is. I might turn that camera off by accident. Yeah. That'll be fine. The drill will run on that just fine too. Okay. Didn't get my vice grips. My protein bar's starting to wear off. I'm gonna either have to eat another one or get something to help me tie it over. No, I don't like drilling through my table, even though there's holes in it. Still don't like doing that, so that's why I'm not doing it. If I don't have to. If it's something I can do without drilling through it, that's what I'll do. Have to drill out bigger holes. Well, I think I'm gonna do that on the inside though, like I said. Yeah. So I need to put my driver in there. First I'll just go in there and drill the sheet metal screws in there, and then I'll drag this inside. Well, I'm sure that's what I need to do. But I will still shut the lid. Leave that. So I need the drill to blow this off. Around that way so I can get that camera out of here. Drill. I don't want to leave those laying out here. Screws. Okay, that's not still plugged in. I smelled a stink bug a while ago. I have to come back and get the camera. I forgot to get my driver attachment. I stuck it in here. Luckily, I do have some drivers in there. My quarter-inch set has, ratchet set has drivers that'll fit in that magnet thing. Because those are hex head, they're not Phillips head. Okay, now, let's see what we can do about getting back in there. You know, it's making me. I don't think I better go without the quarter 20s though, but I'm almost. I'm sitting there thinking, what if it were cold? This is way too much work just to go with a what if. Now that it's turned out to be a whole day's work. Let's put those quarter 20s in there. You know, you think you're only gonna leave it there for a week until you get the parts, but I know from experience that that's not always how things go. Sometimes you don't get to do the work you think you're gonna do, or heck, this really is gonna be very sturdy. Now, if it makes a lot of squealing noises, then it won't be no good. But if it actually is quiet, it's actually gonna be way more sturdy than the plastic crap that's worn out. Well, the first one that was originally put in it, as far as I know, you know, we got it used, but it was my grandmother's. Pretty sure it had never been replaced before. It lasted from 93 until we got it in 95. My mom got it in 95 or something. I don't know, maybe even further on up than that. Until about 10 or 15 years ago. No, probably 5 years ago. And then we put the new one in and now it's already out. Yeah, it was only about five, maybe less. Because I'm... Yeah. So, I think there's a place to plug in a drill. Right there on that light. It's actually handy. That's an ancient drop light handle from the days when they did that always on drop lights. But the top was metal, which was very sturdy, but it burned the living crap out of you with normal bulbs in it, you know? Which is what only thing that, you know, anybody ever used to. And then when they come out with those swirly bulbs at a decent price, I decided, hey, those won't get as hot. Well, I swapped it out. This plastic one, I had two of these plastic ones that I got in the 70s, 80s. This thing was, this handle was in the garage my whole life. I don't know where it came from. This garage here. This is the house I grew up in. And I moved away when I was 18 and then it came back in about 98, 8, 5, 8, something. So anyway. Now let's get our screws. I already had it up. It was laying in the... So, actually, let's just get a little fuse, put it in the lid, because if I accidentally turn something over, I don't want it to be the whole thing. Okay, now, yeah, I need my right hand to do that. This thing doesn't, the magnet doesn't go all the way through the tool, but it's tricky. Yes, if I can get one going, then, yeah. Okay, let's see, a little bit still back there, magnet's still in there, where's my part, let's pull this chair up here, so that I'll have something. You know, I put that chair up there before and it was probably blocking the view. Parts. Yeah, so with my... Where is it? Yeah, so the... How did I plan that? With the space, I'll put sheet metal screws in all of them. But the space, best place I have for a quarter 20 is up there. So what I'll plan on doing is drilling those out to, you know, a little over a quarter inch so I can put the quarter 20 bolts in there. But I'm going to go ahead and put, well, I'll just put these two in. I don't actually need all four. Let's do these two. And then I'll plan on just drilling those out. Yeah, of course. I knew that. Okay. still don't think I have my keys. What's that manual? Oh yeah, I have those marks. Well, I still want that on there. Let's try left-handed then. I don't know if I can drive those left-handed. They're not very big, maybe. Yeah, I can see the marks from here. Just see one of them. Well, I can do that. Yeah. See, oh, those marks are not the ones that are right. Those were the ones that were looking down there. Mark it again, that's all I can do. Mark it with the blue pen. With my new position name, my name is more.
Get a more correct mark. That's good.
Another poking bowl, I guess. I'm close, but I'm running out of juice. Yeah, you need to be down on that thing. I'm gonna make a mark where those original marks are. Then they come Saturday. Yeah, it takes a little longer than I thought. I thought it'd be about 3 days. I pulled the drill out without thinking that I can use it. I didn't want it falling. And it doesn't matter if it falls or not. Yeah, that's pretty good. So that was where I marked that one. This is going to be right out, but I'm going to take off the time for the to be around the other side. Okay. I think I'm gonna have to trust my marks. Yeah, I'm gonna have to trust my marks so that I can actually drive a screw. I think that drill would be less than that way if I record, would be less than that way if I pull it out. So. Okay, now. I may be in the way here, but I'm not going to reposition. But let's see. Yeah, I need to sit down in the chair to where I can see those marks. And also not be killing myself again. Oh, now I can get that. Get that thing out of there. That fan's blowing on it. Drying it out. You know, alcohol makes those things start working again for a little while anyway. Regular rubbing alcohol, of course it's got a little water in it. Denatured alcohol I think would be better. I think I've tried both. There's a step down there, and this chair just rolled right up there. I'm going to try to do it without the chair. It's hard for me to squat down and all that stuff. I won't get hurt. I'll sit down. That's what I'll do. Okay. Yeah, now I can see my marks. And maybe you can see the back of my head. Let's was wide open, so you just put it on and put it in the door. It didn't fall in the motor. I thought I heard it put in the bottom. I think I better go get a magnet because the grabber. The end of this, it's not strong enough to pick anything up. I think I'll just take that out of there. Okay, well let's check that alignment. Let's not forget that. Trying to figure out what's most important to do first. It won't completely spin all the way around, but it is in there, so I think it's close enough because that thing, it keeps working until it gets way, way off. So, you get this drill unplugged. I gotta get another poking wire. I guess I'll turn this off until I come back to next year. Next step, oh no, I gotta drill those holes. Don't quit yet. You gotta drill those holes. I gotta go get the drill bits and stuff. I get a protein bar first. I'm gonna have to. So I'll turn the camera off until I come back. It almost feels like it would hold with those. There's a lot of weight gets put on that though. I think it would probably stay with four of those sheet metal screws, but I'm not going to risk that. Actually, if I'd have did it the other way and came from the back because I guess I could do that with bigger ones. But yeah, if I would have came the other way and the threads were going into, of course, then the screws, they don't do that very good. They break a lot. Trying to go into thick metal like that angle iron. But that metal on the driver's thicker than I thought it was. I'm not quite sure why they use that little thin piece of metal to hold it all together. Anyway, I'm going to go get a protein bar and a drink and get my drill bits and stuff.